Hey, what's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back to another Genshin Impact video. I'm going to be making a video today about Kazuha. He's about to be coming to Genshin Impact in about, 2 weeks almost. That's not a lot of time. So let's just talk about some of the things that you guys might want to start doing or might to start want to think about, because he's coming very soon, like extremely soon. So I just wanted to get ready, get excited. He is on his way. So, first things first, am I going to be pulling on Kazuha? Not on this account, no, but I will be showing you guys some weapons and stuff that might be useful for any of you guys who do not have an account that's very, how do you say this, pay to win. So, if you have a low spending account or maybe even a free to play account, which is probably the case, I'm gonna show you guys some good options if you have those weapons, of course. And also, I'm gonna be talking about some of the stuff that he might need, so you guys might need to grind in the future or even now, possibly, for what he's going to need as ascension materials or whatever it may be. Disclaimer, this is big disclaimer, I'm gonna put it on my screen right here. If you guys don't want to know anything about Kazuha any way, shape or form, even how to prepare for him, please click out of the video. Do not watch the rest of the video. I won't be spoiling any skills or any ultimates, whatever it may be. I won't be showing any of that, so if you think that's what this is, it's not, so you don't have to worry about that too much. So yeah, anyways, we'll just get a move on. Guys, Kazuha is about to come out. We're going to need a lot of ascension materials. Namely, this stuff. You're going to need a few of these. You don't need too many of those, so you don't have to grind too hard for that. Also, you can also convert it in the alchemy table, so you don't have to think about that too much. Also, he's going to need an ascension material that isn't found in the normal world. Which is this stuff. You're going to need a bunch. The only way that I found right now that you could get any of those materials is through the Golden Apple Archipelago. I haven't seen it anywhere else, so I'm not really quite sure how to get it or unlock it. It is what it is, really. So, you're going to need a bunch of those, maybe around 170 of that if you wanted to take it to level 90, 110 if you just wanted to be level 80, which is also, you know, fine. Alright, so you're going to need that, but you're also going to need the new boss materials. And the new boss is the person over here, the Yaksha boss. If I can just teleport over here, I can show you guys how the boss looks like. Okay, so here is the boss. This is what the boss currently looks like. He's currently inactive and you can't get him right now, but he is going to be unlocked within the next few days, so you guys can hopefully grind that out when he's out. But for right now, you're going to need a bunch of his materials, namely 46 if you want him to get to 90. I think it's around 46, don't quote me on that. Maybe 46, 48. I'm not really quite sure how much you're going to need of it, but yeah, you're going to need a number around that. So grind this a lot. I'm not quite sure where this boss is going to end up in the actual world, because this whole limited time air is going to go away. So I'm not quite sure how you're going to fight this boss. You're going to probably fight him in an Azuma, which is going to be pretty fun either way. And another thing is you're going to need around 420,000 gold or Mora. So you need to grind up your Mora as well if you don't have enough already. And the other thing that you're going to need is this stuff right here. You're going to need about 36 of the stuff you want to go to level 90, and 30 of these ones, and around 20 of this, maybe 18, I'm not quite sure. So you need a bunch of those. Obviously, you're going to need one of a lot of the other materials, these ones. You're gonna need a bunch of these. You're gonna need 9 of this, 9 of this, and only one of these. So if you have a bunch, you could just like turn them into these. So yeah, that's that. And then you're going to need 6 of the golden ones, the golden one of these, which is, it's pretty expensive for level 90. So I mean, hopefully it is worth it. All right, we talked about his ascension materials, and when he's going to release, but we didn't talk about some of his weapons that you might have. I myself do not have a golden weapon, aka a 5-star weapon. It's quite unfortunate that I don't have one, but it is what it is, really. So let's just talk about some of the weapons that you guys might have, especially me on my free-to-play account. So let's just move on. So we have the prototype ranker. This is the free sword they pretty much give you if you reach like adventure rank 10 or 7. I don't remember, but this one has a physical damage bonus and a pretty high base attack, but it's not really useful for what he's going to, you know, do. But it isn't bad, and you get a 16% attack increase for his normal or charge attacks. You're not going to be using his normal charge attacks really, but if it's strong, if it has a high multiplier, I don't see why not. But if this is the only 4-star weapon you have, you might need to consider using a 3-star weapon. Alright, moving on, the sacrificial sword. It has energy recharge and a base attack for 101. So is energy recharge going to be any good on him in general? I honestly don't know, just because of the reason I don't know how much his ultimate needs. For example, the energy cost for youll's ultimate is around 80. I don't think it's going to be 80. It's either going to be 40 or 60. In that case, having a, you know, if it's 60 energy cost, sacrificial sword will do you amazing. It'll pretty much be up all the time, but I doubt you're going to need a sacrificial sword. Why I say that is because you're going to have his, you know, his old E ability. His E ability is going to give you a lot of animal particles. That'll be okay for you, but you're probably going to run animal with another animal. For example, if you have sucrose. Sucrose is going to give you the entire battery that you need, all the battery in the world. She's going to have your ultimate up in no time. So if you don't want to use sacrificial sword, you're going to opt for another weapon. Another weapon would be the flute. The flute is attack percentage. I would never recommend this to anyone unless you're using it on Genshin, maybe. And even on Genshin, it's not really the best. So another energy recharge sword is the Favonius sword. So this sword is going to generate a lot of particles. So if you just want him, Kazuha himself, without any other animal character on your team, this sword is great. It'll pretty much get your ultimate up pretty fast. So if you're a low spender or you just buy the battle pass, you might have the black sword. I feel like this will be an okay weapon for him. It's not going to be a good weapon, that's for sure, but it's going to be an okay weapon because you're not going to be using, you know, much. It is what it is, but it does give crit rate. And that's the only reason I'm like, it might be good, just because it has a crit rate stat. Of course, the 5-star weapons are going to be like 100 million times better, right? For example, the sword that's going to be coming along with Kazuha, it was called the Freedom Sworn. If you guys don't know about this sword, it's the brand new sword that's going to be coming out with Kazuha. It's in its own banner. That on it is the Elemental Mastery stat. It's going to start with a base of 40 or something like that, which is going to help his Elemental Mastery, because his whole kit is based around Elemental Mastery. So it's going to increase the damage by I don't know how much. It's going to be crazy. It's going to be his best in slot for sure. But moving on, there is an Elemental Mastery weapon that's a 4-star that's pretty much obtainable. This is called the Iron Sting. The Iron Sting starts with a basic attack of 42 and Elemental Mastery of 36. This isn't bad. I feel like this would be an okay weapon. The only reason I say that is because your whole elemental damage is going to be increasing all your damage by 6% for 6 seconds, but it maxes for 2 stacks, which means 12%. If you have multiple of this, which you can make multiple of, you're going to be in good shape. You're going to be in a good place because it's going to increase the all damage by a bunch. So this might be his best in slot for Kazuha if you're, you know, free to play player. But I'm not going to go there just yet, just because I haven't tried it on him. Unless you're using Kaching, it sucks. So yeah, try to avoid that best as possible. Let's talk about the Harbinger of Dawn. This is an amazing weapon for anyone to use solely because of this. Crit damage, crit rate, both there, especially if you have a Refinement 5. I have a Refinement 5, so that's why it's like a lot here. But I don't think it's his best in slot, for sure. I definitely doubt it would be his best in slot. Just because this exists and the Freedom Sworn exists and other 5-star weapons exist, such as the Primordial Jade. Okay, moving on, the Skyrider Sword. Skyrider Sword is probably going to be the worst weapon. I'm joking, this weapon might be actually good. Because using an elemental burst grants 34% increase in attack and movement speed. It's good. Definitely good, but I don't know if you would want to use this. There is another weapon I want to show everyone here. There it is. This is the weapon that you guys see on his whole trailer. It's called the Fillet Blade. It has an attack percentage and some of this stuff. It's pretty much prototype Rancor or prototype Archaic, but in a sword form. It's not really good and I wouldn't recommend it to anyone. Don't use the Traveler's Handy Sword, just don't. And now we go on to the probably the best 3-star option for him. I say that because it has an elemental mastery substat as well as a substat of upon causing overload, the superconduct electro charge or an electro infused swirl reaction, attacks increase by 20% for 12 seconds. Obviously, you don't have any refinements for this, so it's probably going to be 20% for the rest of the time. If you have official on your team, you just pop the E and boom, you already have the electro infused swirl reaction all the time. So you're probably just going to, you know, official E and then just use the elemental skill for Kazuha. So, I mean, it's going to be pretty okay, this weapon. So if you don't have any other options, this is pretty much a free weapon which you can get. And I don't think it would be a bad option in my opinion. But yeah, alright. I mean, that's pretty much it for the weapons. I don't have any 5-star weapons to show you guys. But if we're talking Aquila Favonia, avoid it at all costs. The new Freedom Sworn, best in slot. Primordial Jade Cutter. It's going to be good just for the crit rate. But I don't think it's going to be the best in slot. The Summit Shaper, it's always good if you have someone with a shield. The Skyward Blade with energy recharge is probably going to be okay. But it's not going to be the best in slot either. Just because he literally solely uses Elemental Mastery. And I'm not quite sure how that's going to work just yet. Alright, that was a lot of talking. How about we try to replicate what... Oh, this is how it will work. You would drop Fisher right here. And then just swirl as many times as you want. Yeah. That just goes crazy, right? And this is my Kazuha. Look at this, my Kazuha is going crazy. I already have my ultimate. If you guys see in the bottom right. I'm just saying, Sucrose would be a really good battery for any animal character, really. But yeah, she'd work well with what's his face, Kazuha. So I wouldn't be surprised. Oh look, this is my Kazuha ultimate right here. Obviously the damage is not going to look like this. Not even... I mean, it's not gonna even look like this, right? So, keep that in mind too. But I do have a Black Cliff weapon. Alright ladies and gents, that's going to be it for today's video. Hope you guys did enjoy. If you did, consider liking the video, subscribing to the channel as well. I will see you guys very soon with another video. Goodbye.